This is a tutorial for iScaf 6.7. Here is our setup where we have two decks, one at 8 metres and one at 6 metres. We have two bays already built, and this advanced tutorial will show you how you can vary the sizes of your side brackets within a bay of scaffold. We will add side brackets to this scaffold by clicking on the toolbar and then clicking on the side bracket option. If you would like a corner bracket, you can also add those as well. Also, the other method with changing the side brackets or adding side brackets is to use the fast edit option. Again, this is in the toolbar. Click on the edit plan option, click on the bay, select properties, then side brackets. And you can actually point to the actual direction where you want the side brackets to appear. Now, if you want a corner bracket, use the same method and point to the corner. So as you can see, we can connect side brackets in any direction. Stay in the edit plan mode and change any side bracket by simply clicking on it. Go to properties and select the size you want, and it will either stretch or reduce depending on the size you selected. Let's do this again for the other side. Go to properties, I'll select a smaller size, and that is automatically changed. If we build this to 3D, the system will automatically calculate the correct quantities for those side brackets and corner brackets. We can actually vary the side brackets at every level. This can be done by clicking the Edit Wall option. Click on the bay, select the side decks. As we can see, we have two levels of side brackets. Click on Set Side. And we can actually view the side brackets at every level. So at the 8 metre level, we have a 3 board on the west. And also we have a 3 board on the west for the 6 metre height. We can change this. We can actually say at the 8 metre height. Let's make it a 2 board and click OK. So if we view this again, we see that on the west, at the 6 metre height, we have a 3-board side bracket. At the 8 metre height, we have a 2-board side bracket. Click OK. We apply this to the selection. So we want to apply this to this particular bay because we don't want any of the other bays to be affected. Now, when we build this to 3D, we see that on the right-hand side, we have the 1-board side brackets as requested. And on the left-hand side, at the 6 metre height, we have the 3-board side bracket. And at the 8 metre height, we have the 2-board side bracket as requested. Viewing the scaffolding in 3D from this perspective, we can actually click on the quote button to interrogate the scaffold. Our full material list shows the side brackets that we have included in our quote and the internal corner fillers or corner brackets identified in this quote as well. We can identify each component individually by clicking on the quote button separately and then clicking on the actual corner components individually. So if we right click here, we see that we correctly identified a 1x2 left corner filler on the right hand side. And we click on quote again, we can actually click on this corner bracket here, see that it's a 2x2 corner filler, and finally, right here, We click on that corner bracket, and we see that that's correctly identified as a 2x3 corner filler. Finally, a quick reminder that in your material list, you can change the part numbers, item codes, and descriptions yourself to identify components.